And a good Friday to everybody. Hope everybody's doing okay. My name is Jewel, and this is the Weather Channel of J7409. Thank you so much for clicking play and checking out the weather with me today. Folks, everything's over on the community page for things coming up next week, which is going to be a big change for many of us. Cold. Some of the coldest temperatures yet in certain areas are going to arrive next week. Now, you need to prepare for this because this is going to be bitter cold all the way down in these areas here where we've had cold, but nothing like what's coming. Some of the daytime highs may not get out of the 20 or 30s with nighttime lows, teens, or maybe zero in some places. It's a mess. The map we're looking at right now is set for 5 o'clock this afternoon. This is what it's going to be looking like. Now, light snow and blizzard conditions, they should gradually diminish across the northern plains today. However, heavy snow will impact portions of the inter-northeast, okay, through this weekend. So stick around. I'm going to go ahead and show you what it's looking like coming up for next week, because next week is just going to be something that we haven't experienced as of yet. Here we have the regular GFS map, and the GFS map now, along with the Euro, the Canadian models, they're not quite in agreement right now. But if you remember, for those of you who follow me, yesterday I was on the Euro map, and it looked like snow coming down in these areas here next week. Not this, the rest of this week, but this coming week, next week. Folks, it's going to be something. Now, this map right here is from today, and it will run through New Year's Day. So I'm going to turn it on, and I'm going to let you see what's happening and what happened. What could be happening is on the way. Now, the main weather story that will make the weather headlines next week will be this massive, expansive area of frigid temperatures from northern and all areas of Montana, the northern plains, to the Midwest, and even the Ohio Valley. Now, a couple of reinforcing cold fronts, they're going to usher in the coldest air of the season by a considerable margin, with the expectation of widespread sub-zero readings for overnight lows from the northern Rockies to the central and northern plains and the upper Midwest, with some lows approaching minus 30 degrees across portions of Montana and North Dakota. Now, although this frigid air mass will modify just a little as it reaches the Ohio Valley and the Mid-South, it's still going to be quite cold. It's going to be quite cold with widespread, now listen up, zeros and tens for overnight lows by the end of the week. And this is very cold, this very, very, very cold. It's more than what we've had all this season. And it is expected to have some staying power. It's just going to hang around. Now, I talked about snow yesterday. The potential for an East Coast winter storm late in the forecast also bears close monitoring. Please watch this daily. Keep up with it. Watch your local forecast also. Now, it's looking like the overall upper level pattern is generally supported of a winter storm developing in this region, although model differences, as I spoke of, run, they have some limited confidence and then some expected confidence. We're just going to have to watch it. Now, the expected placement of the heaviest snow is what we've got to look out for, and we're going to have to keep up with this on a daily basis because it could change. It's kind of like a hurricane. We're gonna have to watch it. Now, a low track just off the coast would favor significant snowfall for Interstate 95 corridor, whereas a track along the coast or just inland a little bit would likely have a wintry mix with rain, snow, and freezing rain. Elsewhere, we got a short wave that's going to be tracking near the Gulf Coast along with an associated frontal wave over the northern Gulf of Mexico. Now, that's going to produce an enhanced chance of rainfall across portions of southern Texas and Louisiana Monday, this coming Monday, and then into Florida on Tuesday. Now, the Northwest should see multiple episodes of rain and higher elevation snow, with the highest totals. They're looking like the favored over all of the terrain of those areas. The confidence right now for the best details look like they are at the moderate range. They're not at a low range or a high range. It's once again something we're going to have to watch, because these cold temperatures, for example, like where I'm at, I may have daytime highs in the 20s or 30s with nighttime lows in the teens, possibly single digits. This is going to cause a problem, folks, this cold weather. Let's pray it don't happen to be as cold as it looks like it's going to be right now. So everybody, make sure you've got your emergency supplies up. You've got a way to stay warm, if at all possible. Get your blankets out. Huddle up. Make sure you got food and water, because power could go out, as we know. And some ice is going to start forming also, where we have this mixture of rain and snow with the low temperatures. You can see the ice right in here moving on up. This is right after Christmas. And at Christmas time, it's snow right in this area, what it's looking like now. The GFS map is usually pretty good when it comes to snow, more so than hurricanes. It don't take it as long to get in sync with the Euro. Now, we're just going to have to wait and see what happens, but I'm trying to give you folks a head up. So please, please pay attention and keep up with the daily weather forecast as this system approaches. Have yourself a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day, my friends. I love each and every one of you, and I thank all of you for everything you do for me. Please stay warm. Get prepared. Get prepared for next week, this coming week. Cold, cold. Snow in places we haven't had it before at this time of the year. All kind of things could happen. I hope they don't. But it looks like right now there is that good chance of it. So, get prepared. Stay safe. Stay warm, my friends. Peace, love, and kindness to all. And please, subscribe, click the J7409 Weather Ensemble in the bottom right-hand corner, click the bell, and check off all to make sure you get all my latest forecasts. And please share this information with your friends, your family, and on your social media to help me keep people aware and safe of just what might be coming their way. So with all that said and done, I love you all. Have yourself a blessed day.